I told that mother that we would do something. That was a sad, sad wake. And that father, too many funerals, Ramos, Lute, the names and the list goes on. We need to protect our offices. We need to protect our families.
Welcome to Your Voice with Senator Marty Golden. I'm your host, Julia Locandy. Hi, Senator. How are you?
Good afternoon, Julia. How are you?
Very well. So today, the Senate is going to pass Officer Randolph Holder's law. So usually when the laws have a person's name in it, it's from some sort of tragedy. Could you tell us about Officer Holder?
Yes, Randolph Holder was an upstanding police officer doing his job. And this individual who had been diverted from a drug program, from jail to a drug program, and he had five felonies. And I'm talking about horrendous felonies. And he was released against the prosecutor's objection. And he was released to the street to another drug diversion program. And he went and took this police officer's life. This bill would change that. And it would put caps. There couldn't be any more than anybody who's been arrested with two felonies could not get a diversion, and that the prosecutor has the last say. And this bill is a good bill. It's a bill that helps our officers across this great state. But to be burying the number of officers that we're burying, 750 of them assaulted last year, it's time. It's got to stop. So this family, Mr. and Mrs. Holder, I go to these wakes on a regular basis, and this one was just very striking to me because there's no reason for it. There's no reason for any of them, but this one here, when the judge goes over the prosecutor and says, no, we're going to give him, we're going to divert him and from jail into a program, drug program, and puts him back on the street. That to me was not only taking that life, but that family is ruined. And of course, the city of New York paid a heavy price with another police officer dead. And so this bill will help to stop that.
Do you have an assembly sponsor?
Yes, we're working with Nicole Malliotakis and some of the Democrats to get this bill done. This is a bill that's important, like I said. Why would you give a guy five, six, seven, eight felonies? How could you keep on giving him drug diversion? And we look around the city and state today with the number of heroin debts and fentanyl. It's absurd. You can't be diverting these people. You got to turn around. If they've got a number of felonies, there's only one place for that person to be. You can't give a person three, four, five, six chances. Diversion is for that low-level crime. It's for a person that's went off track. It's for a person that we can get back on track and give them the opportunity to have a good quality of life and to get away from crime. It's not for the habitual crime that they are committing, and the cases upon cases upon cases. We need to put these people where they belong, in jail, diversion where it works, no diversion over two felonies.